I don't mean this speech as a very formal speech which you will not remember. Take me as an elder brother. I am technically a younger brother who is in 7th grade right now. He also goes to an amazing school, very hands-on. I am already excited to be here at this campus. So, you know, take this as an advice from an elder brother to you about how you should go about if you want to be here. Take your hands-on experience to a whole new level and actually build projects that are implemented in the world, in the real world, not just in your science app. Right? So this is like advice you from your editor. Hard work business guy, you don't have to be a commerce student. You know, these labels work this good for education purposes, then you know this is what I learn. It's not necessarily what you do. I mean, when as you've seen my TED talk, when I was started, I was in 8th grade. I had no background. I was not from a tech background or a management background. I was there to solve a problem. And I only wanted to focus on the solution. When I saw it better, and I used to keep thinking, how can I contribute to this project? Later on, the idea is that being in my suggestions were working, but there was something more. My teammates were all electronics engineering students. So I thought, there must be someone who knows how to make software and apps and solar work. Problem solvers don't have labels. They just solve, whatever is needed. You acquire knowledge. If you're curious enough, go on the internet. It's not free. I taught myself how to code online. I just went online and searched, learn how to program. That's how. Then I made this search 6 years ago. And even today, I'm learning how to program. I never did. Do things. So then I said my work, all of these labels that I carried, CTO of my startup and entrepreneur, social entrepreneur, sometimes people just say like a coder. The thing is, it's there just to make it convenient for people to remember it, but that these labels don't define it. That this is not who you are. You are what you do, what you want to do, what you wish to do. How many of you have heard the word network? These corporate people or your mom and dad saying, I'll tap into a network and get leads from all this business jargon. How many of you can have a phone hand up? Have you heard the word network in amongst of people, not ever? Yeah. It sounds very kind of, so it sounds very intimidating and network, oh my god, it must be something that adults do, something that grown-ups do, grown-ups have networks. Did you see the plastic bottle boat that was on that picture? We actually did this boat. It could carry 250 kgs of weight and we took it for a spin. How did you build it? We acquired 500 scrap plastic bottles which were in there. Now, how do you think? Are those people generally crush the bottle anymore? How do you get 500 intact 500 plastic bottles? So, I'll give you an example of my uncle. Okay, I am very close to my uncle and he is like my mentor since my childhood. Before I met all my gurus in technology, my uncle was my idol because he was the closest man to engineer in my family because of all business and CA. So he would explain me things and most importantly, I realized that he knew a lot of people. I did not know the word network, but he knew a lot of people. And as I said, Kaka, I want to make this boat, I want 500 bottles, plastic bottles. He did not know where it was 500 bottles, but he would call someone, ask for them. All you have to do sometimes is ask for help and you receive it. It is the people you know who will help you. For example, through I have been observing this, my uncle won't be able to do everything for me. He won't be able to buy operative for my project. He won't be able to give me insight on the city sewage system, for example. But he know people who can get access. the right way. You always return the favor. If some people ask for help from you, you help first, and that's how you build a connection. This is your network, and you don't have to be a grown up, you don't have to have a job or do anything for that matter. Once you start existing, you can start building a network. Just be good friends with people, and you have a very strong network that is in the corporate. Right? So today, if I want to achieve something, today I want to work on a project. That I want to know how plumbing system goes, I have to work on water management, I know whom to call. If that person in that uncle doesn't know or cannot greatly help me, he at least point me towards someone else. That's how a lot of times you can't do everything in your project. Whatever you want to achieve, you can't do everything. Even if you want to, you need help from people. This is how you get help. Okay, don't get stuck. If you're stuck somewhere, ask for someone, your mom or dad, someone wants to know someone. This is how the game goes, and this is how you could flourish your knowledge, an example of how you could use this, you could go to factories, stuff where big machines are manufactured. So I wanted an internship in any factory. So my uncle, one of my uncle's friends, has a factory where they crush defective talking bags. Those travel bag suitcases, they crush those and make it into particles. So I just sat there for a month. That's how it's an internship per se. You could gain learning experiences through these networks. You could have help building your projects or your mentors with these networks. It is a very valuable lesson if you want to take your hands-on knowledge to a real-world scale. People who are industry connected can really get things to work. And they also love to help people who are doing something different. They also bored of doing the same thing every day. Right? Go ask them questions, don't hesitate. Try and find different things. So these pictures represent some of the things I've done in my childhood. I've tried to play cricket, Mallam, the dashboard, and not sure how everyone knows this. We basically do yoga on the board. So I've done stadium where I still practice it for my fitness every day. Archery, they say my hand is effective, so no use. And I have tried competitive mathematics, Olympiad, exams. I realized it's not high enough of the. Try your hand for a month or two at least. Go learn an instrument, just for the fun of it. If it doesn't interest you, you could always do something else. There's so many things. In 21st century, we have so much access to things. Use it, and also have fun. These are my three pieces of advice. You are very smart kids, so I did not want to say things that were obvious. Be inspired, be motivated. I know all of you are very motivated. I saw your enthusiasm, and I have been a part of such crowds before. I know we are very enthusiastic. We just need some. I was lucky enough that my ideas were heard and someone said, I will support you. The important thing to remember is, if you are willing to put a lot of efforts, if you are willing to do something different, go reach out to people. There will be many people who will be ready to help you. Don't hesitate to ask for help and don't stop trying new things. So yeah, that's it. And go to events. Events like these, congratulations, you're a part of such event. And go to many more such events. Discover, you'll again build network, and you'll gain experiences that form you as an innovator, as an entrepreneur, as a person. So congratulations on being here, by the way. Thank you.
Wow, Nilay, that was really inspiring.